Good morning, Jerry.
How are you?
I'm doing great, thank you. I love your haircut.
Thank you. It's nice for the summer.
Yes.
Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
Hey,
good morning.
Hey,
I'm so sorry that I didn't recognize your voice.
It's okay. At first, I didn't recognize yours either. It may have been a bad connection.
Well, we have such a beautiful voice.
Good morning.
That's right. It had to be a bad connection.
That's right.
Hey, good morning. Rich
good morning.
Neville.
Good morning. It's a pleasure to meet you. Nydia,
hey.
Tisdale.
Hey.
Good morning.
Hi.
Where did you go?
Right here, behind you.
No, not at all. Good morning, Mr. Smith. Nice to see you as well. Mr. P. I have these for Perry. Been working hard. Yes, well. You're busy, lady. Keep it people straight. Good. Thank you very much, Mr. Perry. Would you practice today?
Yes, those are fresh. Yes, we usually just use them for the hearing, but I brought them today to make sure that we had extra eyes to brief them.
Oh, extra eyes always good.
And Dr. Howell, I have your old one that says chairman if you would like it.
Skowronski.
That's how I'm. The meeting starts and they close the door because we've got campers that are in and out. So I'm trying to get them.
What campers?
It's fire camp. So I think it's for rising sixth graders. They go through drills, fire drills.
I know something about that.
Yeah, it's I think the third year in operation, and it's been a little successful. Everybody has a good place on it.
Coordinated through the school?
They send it out. It's basically community-wide, anyone, but they do a lot of publicity through the school, but it's just a first come, first served. No, it's just the fire department sponsors it. The public education division are the main organizers.
That's good.
And so they offer, they do it 2 weeks out of the summer in different age groups, but middle school age. And it's fun to see.
They teach storm prevention and what to do in storms too.
I think they do all kinds of things. They're out there with the fire hoses and they talk about, you know, safety and they're wearing their bike helmets.
I'd like to see them hold one of those fire hoses when it's under full pressure.
Yeah. No, it takes about 10 of them.
Until
yes,
tropical storm Andrea.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, tropical storm Andrea cut my trip short.
Get any rain down there?
Oh, yes.
Come home
a little early. Rain with wind.
Did y'all come home early?
I did. Came home.
Did you go across that big bridge then?
I don't think
the
so.
Sky Bridge?
I don't think so.
No, you didn't have to. Where'd you go?
Tampa, and went over to Clearwater Beach, but I was going to stay, we were going to stay 3 days at St. Pete Beach, but when the tropical storm came in, we came home because I wasn't going to stay in my hotel room with my husband and three kids for 3 days.
Did you see a sunset in Clearwater?
Yeah, it was so overcast.
That's a beautiful place, the sunset.
It was good for shelling. We got a lot of nice. It's got a lot of nice shells with the storm. It's been raining.
Okay, you can close the door.
On the record.
Okay, we'll call our June meeting to order. The Civil Service Board, June the 13th, 2013. We're meeting at the Public Safety, South County Public Safety Complex on Setting Down Road. Those present, member Tim Peary, board member Tim Peary, our hearing officer, Mr. Rich Neville, our clerk, Ms. Charity Clark, vice chairman of the board, Dr. A.Y. Howell, and Chairman Terry Smith. Gentlemen, have you had a chance to look at the agenda?
Yes, sir.
Hear a motion to adopt?
Motion to adopt the agenda as presented.
I second the motion.
Motion and second to adopt the agenda. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. Gentlemen, have you had a chance to read the minutes?
Yeah.
Any additions or corrections that anyone would want to know?
Mr. Chairman, I vote accept.
Make a motion to
accept.
Here, second.
Motion and second to accept the minutes of the May 9th, 2013 meeting. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries unanimously. Under item 4, number 1, writ of certiorari for John Gooch.
No report, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. And the writ of mandamus. For this 11 sheriff's office employees?
Yes, sir. The Civil Service Board was named as a party to that lawsuit. I filed a motion to dismiss on behalf of the Civil Service Board. The county and Mrs. Carson also filed a motion to dismiss as well, and those are scheduled for hearing before the court on July the 10th. At this point, the three Superior Court judges have recused themselves from hearing the case, so at some point another judge will be assigned to the case. We don't know who that is yet and haven't received notice, but that's what's scheduled thus far.
So a judge will be appointed before the 10th, and that hearing will go forward on the 10th.
It should be. I can't guarantee when the 9th district is supposed to appoint the judge, and I'm sure they'll do something before then.
He'll have 30 or 60. Will they decide something rather quickly on that?
Just kind of depends on how long the judge needs to decide. He'll probably, assuming the hearing goes through on the 10th, he may or may not make a decision at that hearing. A lot of times, judges will take things under advisement a little later. So I imagine that's what will happen.
Okie dokie. Item number 3, Walter Skowronski. Is that right?
That sounds right, yes.
Okay, that's good. You want to mention that you've got me down, but you got the appeal.
Sure.
I'm sure y'all all got the material on that.
Yeah. Mr. Chairman, I received on behalf of the Civil Service Board from Ms. Pat Carson, I received it on May 16th, a request from Walter Skowronski of this was the Forsyth County Sheriff's Office. He says, please allow this letter to serve as my notice. I desire to formally appeal my dismissal from the sheriff's office on April 26, 2013. He did file an informal appeal. He was served on May 10th, that his informal appeal from Sheriff Piper was denied. So it has went through all of the process and now is before the board. And of course, we have 120 days from the May 16th for the board to hear this appeal.
Okay. Mr. Perry, for your information, the way that we've operated in the past, when we get an appeal, we try to schedule it on a meeting day and our next meeting day, unless we're just completely overloaded and then we have to go off schedule on that. So since we don't have anything, we're looking at July the 11th as our next meeting, and we always reserve the next day in case it's a two-day appeal. Would it be, gentlemen, would you agree that we can schedule it on July the 11th? We will have our meeting, our normal meeting at 9:30, and then we will schedule the hearing for immediately thereafter, which should be somewhere around 10, maybe a little bit before. And then we'll hold the 12th open. Is that agreeable with everybody?
Yes.
I hear a motion to that effect.
So moved.
As a motion and second, that we have the appeal on July the 11th after our monthly meeting, which will be at 9:30 that week. And then we'll start immediately thereafter. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries unanimously. So at least set up for July the 11th. You'll get the paperwork out for that.
Yes, sir. I'll get the paperwork out, and I'll be sure that we have a room available for both days,
okay,
just in case it goes over.
Do you happen to know whether he has an attorney or not? Have you heard anything on that?
I have not received any information from any attorney or any representation.
When you send the letter, you do include the fact that we would like to know that.
I will reach out to him and make sure that he's aware that he needs to advise the board as soon as possible so the county can position properly.
Okay. Yep. Gentlemen, that's all that we have on the agenda. I see no need to go into executive sessions or anything else that you know of.
No, sir.
I hear a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion second that we adjourn. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Motion carries unanimously. Thank you, gentlemen, for coming.
So Thursday, July 11th at 9:30, and
yeah,
I'll get all of that information out.
Okay. No, actually, we need to know so that the county can prepare whether they are going to have an attorney or not.
Mm-hmm. Right. So I'll make sure I reach out to them. And because we had a typo on the signature page from last month, I just corrected that. And so if you guys want to sign this fresh copy, I'll replace it with the one that I wrote on.
What was the typo?
It was a D instead of, it was Judge, and this was for the April minutes. I just thought it'd be better than having a mark on call.
I don't know if y'all heard, but Mr. Piggy was on ESPN the other night. His girls' 15-year-old softball team won the county championship, and he was the coach.
That's awesome.
She takes that out. Would that be a no then?
Well, it might be a stretch of the truth saying that we were on ESPN. From historic Midway Park.
Yeah, it was Judge, I had Judge Bagley delivered and order, and we changed it to hand, so that was correct. So we'll replace that.
What was the, was it a statement?
It was county attorney, coming out in all stars, we defeated the sheriff's running all stars.
Thank you. Have a good day. It's aging, look at his hair, how great since he started coaching.
And so everybody likes their nameplate?
Yes.
Yes, very nice.
You get everything? Give me the double D.
Well, yeah, we probably can put them back in.
Okay.
Let them lapse.
Howell, are you feeling all right?
That one's not mine.
Thank you. This is your room. Have a good day, Mr. Tisdale.
Thank you, Dr. Howell, you do the same.
Yeah, I'll see what this, what I can get for size, and, you know, I can probably either, you know, put it on my CD, or if it's small enough, I can probably.
Yeah, I would be particularly interested in the ending of the meeting and then
the conclusion.
Part of the witnesses testimony and then conclusion. I just want to prepare myself for the process.
Sure.
That's something that would be.
Sure, yeah.
Have a good day.
Thank you, Mr. Perry.